Welcome back to Pathologic. It's about 1 p.m. on day 11. The last thing that happened is we spoke to the Inquisitor right behind me, and in doing so finished the main quest for the day. And what we just found out is that apparently the Great Polyhedron is able to stay standing, despite seemingly having no support structure, because it is drilled deep, deep into the earth. And apparently in being drilled so deep into the earth, like a spike, like a needle, it pierced some sort of a... what the Inquisitor said is most likely a burial pit, where bulls used to be disposed of. And in piercing that, it let out the plague. So the main quest for the day is done, but I still have three side quests to do that are incomplete. So the first one is basically helping the Canes. They want me to help Maria become the new mistress. And one of the things I should do is speak with Capella, which I haven't done yet because Capella is sick, so I'm still looking for Panacea and stuff like that. I don't remember if I have any on me. I can't remember if I ended up giving my Panacea to, Casper? In the Polyhedron Tower? Or not. I'll check in a second. But yeah, she's sick, so I'm gonna need to give her some sort of medicine to speak with her if I want to do this quest to help the Canes out. There's the execution, which is what I got from those, kids. At the town hall, I believe. Yeah, they said a bunch of people were going to be executed. And I believe they said that they were at the cemetery, but the weird thing is I've already been to the cemetery and they don't seem to be there. So I'm supposed to find where the execution of these people is going to take place, but I honestly don't know where they would be if they're not at the cemetery. So I'm probably just going to leave that one and not do it unless I stumble across it. And then the third one we have is, instead of helping the Canes like the first one, this one is actually working against the Canes. This is from the Inquisitor. She wants me to find more information to incriminate Maria with, basically. I've already spoken with Casper, who is the son of Victor Kane. And, well, Casper didn't have that much to tell me. He didn't really have anything in particular to incriminate Maria with. Although, he did say that Maria killed Ava, right? If I remember right. But I guess he didn't have any actual evidence of it. And he basically told me to go speak with little Vlad. So that's where I need to go if I want to find more information about the Bone Steak Lot in particular, and also just Maria in general. Because apparently, little Vlad is actually in love with Maria, so he knows her very well. So I need to go speak with him if I want to find more information out about her and what she's been up to. And also, yeah, apparently when I asked about the bull that was at the Bone Steak Lot, that was dying at the Bone Steak Lot, apparently little Vlad would be the one who would know about that, since they're the ones able to procure bulls. So, two reasons to go see him. So yeah, that's my game plan. Go speak to little Vlad, see what I can find out. Along the way, try to look for any sources of Panacea I can get, although they're scarce, because there's not a lot of children to trade with or anything like that. And, I think that's about it right now. And then try to speak with Capella. So let's go to little Vlad. Oh, right, I didn't check to see whether I had any Panacea. Well, I can't stop right now, I've got a rat on my tail. But we've got a decent amount of time left in the day, so I'm not feeling too bad. I'm just gonna escape into here so I don't get hit with the infection. Alright. Oh wait, of course I don't have any Panacea. Oh, I ducked under it. Yeah, of course I don't have any Panacea. I think I might have had Panacea before, but it doesn't matter because it's all been stolen by those fucking military assholes. Right, that's one of the other sort of unmarked side quests that I personally have, is just attempting to find them so that I can get my stuff back. Right, and where were they again? They were down here. You know what? I think I'm actually going to go back down here after talking with little Vlad. Yeah, I'm in the area, and if they have my stuff, that is invaluable, getting it all back. Because I had so much stuff on me.
Maria will stand up for the children. I'm on her side.
Do you know what happened in the lot yesterday? Yes, of course. It was ugly. Barak is beside himself. Do the Canes have anything to do with it? Wait a minute. No. This can't be. The Canes were within a hair's breadth of destruction. The bull situation was arranged to smear their name and set the people against them. Who gave you this unique idea? Because I can't believe that you've come to this conclusion on your own via logical inference. Well, you're quite right. Aglaya thinks Maria did it. Rubbish. Maria is innocent. Moreover, now I understand that she's our only hope. She's the only one who has the courage to keep building the thing that we've set the foundation of. The cowardly and the weak want the reliability, comfort, and confidence of tomorrow. They also want her dead. If he is in love with her, then I don't really believe him. But what about the kin? It's not like this can be explained to them. The kin is gone. For good, sadly. I can already see that Barak has failed. He's lost everything. So from now on, I will serve her who will construct a new miracle instead of the lost one. I promised to give this to you. It's a panacea. Did I? I don't remember that, and also, I don't think I have any panacea on me. But I guess I'll say it. I need nothing. I've changed. I'll sell my property. The money will go towards the new construction project. The town has to be rebuilt from scratch. So this is how it's going to be for you. He's just giving himself over completely. Bowing at Maria's feet.
There's this thing that needs to be done.
I guess that's it. Does that complete the side quest? Yeah. What an idol? Idel? The haters rest their case. The victors adopt the faith of those they prevailed upon. Everything seems to confirm that Maria is pure as the driven snow. I cannot even imagine all the adoration her subjects will shower her with if she becomes the ruler of these places. So, is Maria actually pure as the driven snow, or is she going to become the evil that Aglaya seems to think she'll become? Is Maria going to be the new Nina, who was also supposedly pure evil? I don't know. Okay, next side quest, sort of, is to go to where the soldiers... Okay, you know what, let's go back inside before that knife hits me in the face. Are we good? Okay, good. Alright, so yeah, my own side quest is to go to where the soldiers took me out. Oh, hey, what the... can I help you? Why do you want to punch me? Whatever. Seriously, why do you want to punch me? What have I ever done to you? I'm gonna have to kill him. He's not gonna go away. Well, anyway. We're gonna have chase music for the next 5 minutes, but yeah, let's go to where the soldiers took me out. Knocked me out. See if they're still there and if I can get my stuff back. If not, I'm gonna be very sad. And then after that, I guess I'm gonna go to Capella. Well, no, there's no point in going to Capella. I don't have any medicine on me because I've lost everything. Well, I do have plenty of money, because strangely enough, they didn't take my money, so I could actually buy medication. It'd be very expensive, though. They're slow. Actually, I can ditch them here. I think I can go in here. Yeah. Hello. You probably have nothing to say. Yep. God, I really, really, really hope they're still here. Please, still be here. Oh my god. They are? They're still here! Yes! Oh, I'm gonna get my stuff back and remember the person was stealing people's panacea. So I should be able to get more panacea from them. There's no point in talking to them, right? No, you know what? Talking before didn't work. I'm not gonna fall for it again. No. You fuckers are going down. Right now. Or I'm going down. How did they hit me? I thought I was undercover. Like, completely undercover. Okay, let's do this from maybe this far away. Yeah. Man, this thing is so accurate. Killed the one behind that person. Oh well, I'll take it. That's gonna use up so much of my ammunition. No, I missed! Wasted ammo. Oh, come on! This thing's at like... It's at 88%. Should be more accurate than this. I'm gonna aim for the crotch, because that's like the most center. So if it shoots a bit high or a bit low, I should still be okay. Or maybe low chest. Yeah, low chest is better. If I aim for the crotch, it could fall low and hit in between their legs. Two at one time. I'll take it. This thing's really getting less and less accurate. What's it at now? 78%. Come on! Is this a rifle or like a freaking shotgun? And if it isn't the head honcho... Hey! Oh man, it looks like your whole... Your whole little battalion here is dead. Doesn't want to talk. Asshole. Down to 6 shots, unfortunately. Can I get my stuff back? Yes, I can. Oh, thank God. So let's see if it does have more panacea. Oh my god, come on. Click faster! Oh my god, this is really tedious. Is there a loot all button? I don't know, maybe if I hold shift and click it'll like loot all, but I'm kinda scared to try it. And there's panacea. I thought they had a bunch of panacea, though. Didn't I already have one panacea? Oh, wait, now I have two. How did I get two panaceas? I'm confused. I don't know where these panaceas came from. Did I already have one on me? I offered one that I didn't think I had to little Vlad, and then... Now I've got more panacea than I thought I had? I'm confused, but I'm not gonna complain about two panacea. Okay, I'm really happy now. Yeah, now I've got tons of ammunition. Let's switch to my other rifle, because this one... The rifle I just picked up is 98% versus my, like, 78% one. So yeah, plenty of ammunition. What about drugs? My health could be higher, but it's I think it's like halfway, it's fine. Do I have anything for immunity? Because my immunity is at half, like half. I don't really want to use that stuff. No, it's fine. I won't use anything. I do need to sleep soon, though. But I think I have... Yeah, I've got coffee beans. Could eat some crackers, that's fine. Alright, yeah, now let's go to Capella. Give her the panacea. And see if I can get the stuff from her that I'm supposed to use to help Maria. But I guess there is the question of, do I want to actually help Maria? The whole thing that she's doing is really quite creepy. I don't know what she or her whole family is doing. Channeling Simon, channeling Nina, becoming a new mistress, something. Do I really want that to happen? I don't know. I don't have any particular reason to not want it to happen, but I'm also very suspicious. Should I try to stop it just because I'm suspicious? I don't know. I guess I'll just roll with it. Oh god. Getting away from that thing. I'm getting worse and worse at dodging those things. Did I just get a new message? Yeah, I think so. A warning from the Haruspex. I have news to share, Oinion. Or Oinon, whatever, however you pronounce that. I found the thing that you were looking for the day before yesterday. Please avoid any rash decisions, at least till you've spoken to me. Meet me at the works in a vault beneath the corpulent workshop. Ew. The thing you were looking for the day before yesterday. What was I looking for the day before yesterday? So that was on day 9, huh? I don't remember. Okay, well, if I'm supposed to avoid any rash decisions before I've spoken with him, then I think I should just go speak with him right now. I'm pretty close to it, after all. Yeah, okay. Vault beneath the corpulent workshop. I forgot which one specifically is the corpulent workshop, but let's assume it's this one, because it's the only one that's actually red. Let's go to the train tracks. I've got a feeling the Corpulent Workshop is actually over there, where Barak was held in a jail cell. But let's try this one. I think the entrance is on the opposite side. Ugh, those noises. Okay, yeah, it's not there.
Oh, man.
Yep, this is the place. What have you found? I've got good news and bad news for you. I'm listening. You asked me to find out the exact location of the underground clot from which the sand pest bacteria could have gotten onto the surface. I did. Have you succeeded? Uh-huh. The thing is, it's everywhere. The deposits are sprawling beneath the whole town like kraken tentacles. They originate in the old cattle husbandry places on the other side of the Gorgon. The ground is soaked in it. The other side of the Gorgon? What the heck is... I don't even know where that is. What's the Gorgon? How did you... Damn it, how did you find this out, Barak? Well, that is unchecked, of course. But the foreman of the butchers immediately knew what I was talking about. He said the deposits do exist. He drew the map of them sprawling underground. Where did they come from? It's a secret, Oinon. I cannot reveal it to you. Okay. Thanks for the info. Doesn't matter. It's obvious anyway. Ancient cattle burial grounds. You said you had more news? The good news is that the deposits lie very deep. They're covered by so many layers of solid soil that no borewell could ever reach them. An extremely deep hole would have to be drilled to puncture those clots and spill their contents into the groundwaters. But it has already been spilled, as you can see. What are the abattoir's thoughts on the matter? The abattoir's voice is my voice now, Oinon. And I'll tell you this. Oyan used to run things poorly. His bloodline was akin to mine, but he kept failing to learn the lines. He has committed numerous mistakes recently. I think it was he that dipped out the pest from the cavities 5 years ago. A bold hypothesis. What about now? I suspect that he tried to bury the pest in the steppe not so long ago. I have no idea why. That was the greatest sacrilege. And my father tried to intervene. He went to the steppe to reinter this nightmarish burial ground. He must have burned it, but couldn't come out unscathed. You know how it went after that. So he came out infected, right? He tried to burn it. He came out infected, and it's him that spread it to everyone, then? As we suspected? Well, I mean, I guess it was going to spread anyway, wouldn't it? How probable is it that your father failed to destroy that gulp? I have other things on my mind now, Oinon. Playing safe is pointless. I'm only thinking about mitigating the consequences of the disaster. I want the sand pest to be no more a threat to the local population than chicken pox is. Well, I've already done it, haven't I? The vaccine has been produced. I think this paragraph is supposed to be ironic. I'm not really sure what tone to read it in. I think it's supposed to be ironic that the Haruspex is a lot less extreme in his approach to solving the problem. I guess he's like, we have the vaccine, we have the serum, so there's nothing else that's really a big problem. But the bachelors, like, burn the whole town to the ground? I'm not sure. Well, I never... spoken like a truly wise man. Thankfully, I, at least, can still keep a cool head. The town is inextricably connected to the soil, and the only way to defeat the disease is by destroying its source. Wait. Do not give out hasty orders. I swear to you, by tomorrow morning, I'll find a way to produce so much medicine for the disease that there won't be a need to destroy it. Hmm. by tomorrow morning. Will it be too late at that point? I don't think so. I think I have till the end of tomorrow. But you don't mean destroying the tower, do you? Yes, God damn it. But only if the people that need to be saved are alive. I've told you about them, remember? The kids that'll build a new town here in 10 years. A town even more beautiful than the current one. Oh my God. What the hell do I do? So he's gonna destroy the tower. The Inquisitor also wants to destroy the tower, I believe. Maria wants to use the tower, I believe, which is gonna force the kids to leave, I think. The changeling has told me that she's going to perform a miracle tomorrow, if all the people on her list are kept alive, which I believe they are at the moment. But what miracle? Is she going to manage to save the tower? Is she going to manage to save everybody? So, he's going to destroy the tower, but he wants the people, the kids, left alive. Okay, well, they're safe inside, so they're fine. I don't know. I don't know what to do. I'll think about it. I think this is new. This is what, the underground burial, I guess? The stuff underneath the roots. Okay. Oh, Jesus Christ. Fuck. I thought it was coming for me. I almost ran right into it. Whew. So that didn't give me a side quest or anything like that. The only thing it's given me is information. And do I have any way of stopping him from destroying the tower? He just claimed he's going to destroy the tower, presumably sometime between now and next morning if he's gonna have so much medicine next morning. It's gotta happen before then. So do I even have any say in the matter? Okay, where to now? Ah, right. I need to go to Capella. Alright, let's go to Capella. Give her the panacea. You know, I should probably also stop at food stores. I'm gonna need food pretty freaking soon here. Oh no, this whole- oh crap. Dead end. Completely dead end. I forgot you have to go all the way around. Like, all the way around. Holy crap. Waste of time to pick up water bottles at this point. Should I stop for food while I'm here? This is a food store. Eh, it's too far out of my way. I'm not comfortable going out of my way that much. I like how that group of four are just staring at that mist of infection. They're just like guarding it. Oh, this is a food store. Cool. Oh, that's so cheap. Vegetables, 1200, dried meat, 480. I'll take all of that. Oh god, oh god, get inside! Oh. You know what I just realized is that keeping the kids alive might not just mean... You know what, it probably doesn't just mean keeping the kids inside of the tower alive. That also probably means I need to give panacea to the kids over here. Remember the kid over here is sick? Even though they're not on the list of people that need to stay alive for the Changeling's miracle? They are kids, and I feel like I should probably give the panacea to them. All right, here's the panacea.
I used to go out in the night only to be found someplace new in the morning.
I realize what your visit means. Victoria, do you know Katarina's successor? Oh, this is so very complicated. First, I was absolutely positive that it was Clara. For a long time, I was sure Clara was the plague itself. I'm ashamed to admit it now that I know for sure that she is a real miracle maker. Perhaps even a saint. Why don't you think so now? Because sometimes it seems to me that there truly are two changelings, a good one and an evil one. On the other hand, I know for sure that it cannot be so. She doesn't seem deranged to me, nor do I believe that she has split personality. All in all, it is all very weird. I have heard time and time again about there sounding like there's multiple changelings. Everything from the miracle-making changeling, to the imposter of the changeling that doesn't even have legs, just like bloody stumps. Remember, that's what the cemetery person, I think her name's Gloria? That's what she said. What bothers you about Clara? I'm worried that she's clinging to the commander too much. A very peculiar ally. Perhaps there's nothing bad about it. Perhaps she wants to influence him with her blessed powers, to quench his cruelty. But there's something unnatural about this union. Why? The sixth sense has never betrayed me. It is as though she was looking for a powerful destroyer in him. Or maybe she is just tricking him to subdue his will. In any case, I don't like it. Is that going to be her miracle? Is that what her miracle is leading up to? Controlling the commander to do something? I know what you mean. This changeling is very dangerous.
What?
I shall speak on Maria's behalf. Well, it's for the better. A new colorful star is rising in our skies, for the first time in many years. All hail its ascent. You sound sad. Yes, I realize this. Who knows how many years will pass before I come into power? Very many, perhaps. And the only thing left for me will be taking up residence in the town Maria will have built, and accepting the place she will have appointed to me, if there is one. So it cannot be changed now, can it? What are you talking about? If only it was possible to wait just a little. I could lead everybody down a very different path. It would be so much better. How would you change the town? Oh, I have grand designs. I would change it completely. You know, it's scarlet now. Scarlet and navy and... I don't remember how to pronounce that color. Taupe? I would make it golden, and chalk, and cinnamon, and chestnut. We'd have new powers, new ideas, new aspirations. It would be completely different. Would it be better? Well, I was so close. But the town is better off with a dark mistress than with none at all. We cannot stall any longer. Especially since dark doesn't really mean evil. And Nina wasn't a dark mistress. She was the mistress of the night. They even called her Scarlet. Scarlet Nina. Scarlet Maria. Dark mistress does sound foreboding, but... being mistress of the night... if that's what being a dark mistress means, mistress of the night, that doesn't necessarily mean it's something bad or evil. Do you acknowledge her power? Here, give Maria my beads. This jewelry belonged to my mother. An antique work made of the bone of a steppe bull. These bulls are extinct now. Here, see? The protective brands are carved upon the spikes. I acknowledge her power. Let her reign better than Wild Nina did. Thank you. Don't be sad. What if I mean, this is a side quest. What if I don't do this side quest? I feel like I'm gonna change everything. Maria won't become the leader or something? I don't know what the hell's gonna happen tomorrow. And I have so little information, I really can't say what I should do. Let's see. Capella has embraced the rule of the future mistress. As a token of her love and obedience, she has offered her mother's necklace to Maria Kena. I am going to go give my panacea to the kid. Should I? I feel like I should. I'm gonna go do it. I pray I don't regret this. I pray I... oh, fuck you. It's a dead end. I pray that there isn't a moment tomorrow where I need panacea and I don't have one on me. I'm gonna be so sad if that happens. So I'm gonna make a permasave right before I give it to the kid. This place is clear of infection, so there could be kids to trade with. The chance of them having a panacea is extraordinarily low, but it is possible. The kids sometimes do have it. Bandage? No bandage. Might as well take a stop at grief.
Ain't that a mess?
Don't suppose you have any panacea? Of course you don't. Do I want any of this? Nope. Is this zone over here infected? No, it's not. Bandage? Bandage! You know what? You look like such a nice guy. I'm gonna give you 6 bottles, even though you only need 5. There you go. Drink to your heart's content. Alright, let's make a permasave in case I regret this and want to come back. Of course, I'm sure that they have nothing to actually say to me.
I smell smoke.
Yep, nothing. I can't talk to the other children, right? They don't even say thanks. Let's go give the beads to Maria. Yeah, I think I've cured every single person who's gotten sick except for Big Vlad. And I'm not sure if I even had a choice to cure Big Vlad or if that happened. You know, maybe it's unavoidable? I don't know. Either it's unavoidable or I neglected him for more than a day. Because as far as I know, you have the entire day to deal with someone being sick. Like, at least one day, possibly more, for all I know, but you have at least one full day to deal with it, I think. God. Get inside. Too many things flying. How am I looking on... Ooh. How am I looking on medicine? By the way, do I have some? I've got one Meridorm. That's not gonna be enough to heal me. When I go to sleep, I'm gonna wanna stop by a medicine store, probably. I think there's a medicine store right up here on the right. Or wait, I think it's this one right here, actually. Yeah, here we go. $1,200 is a steep price to pay compared to trading for it, but I can't find anybody to trade with. So... I'll take it. What about immunity? Oh, these are garbage. Those are garbage, I'm not gonna pay for them. I've got 15,000 money left, it's fine. I can spend I can be a bit wasteful. Oh, wait a minute. Where is Maria? Right, she's... the door's locked and everything, right? Oh god. I need to find her, don't I? I've seen a shade of Scarlet Nina's silhouette and stature rush towards the Crypt's Gate. Right, that's my hint. The Crypt's Gate. Where's the crypt? What crypt? I know I've already looked here, which is where I thought she might be, and she wasn't here. I really do still need to find her, don't I? A crypt. I don't know. Alright, well, I think I'm gonna save that for the next episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far. And when I return, I'm gonna search for Maria.